go. Good whistle. Oh. All right, that was a violation, guys. Oh, that'd have been yours, John. All right, remember we just talked about that before it happened. The guy stealing that, you cannot let that happen. Jeff, way to stay on that 3-point. I was actually in the C's, but the C wasn't paying attention to it, so I was good. Staying strong in your primary. Yep, that was a push. That was a good get. All right, Josh, that was great. That's what we're looking for. We want to get those pushes. That was just a dumb foul. Good rotation. One thing about this game is we do have some big guys, so post position is going to be important on our rotations and our matchups. Yep, good rotation. Nice travel, Josh. Okay, John, you got subs. John, you got subs. All right, Josh, that was excellent. Now we as a crew have determined that we're calling illegal screens, travels, and the pushes in the back, right? Oh, all clean. Thank you. John, we're talking about as a C, you were way down here to try to get the look, right? We'd rather have you arc up and come up that way to get the view. John, you were the C, and 30 had the ball and was spinning around. Watch on the tape. That defender had both of his hands on his back the whole time. That is the stuff we need to call. That is two hands on the dribble. That's what we're talking about. Get to our base. Okay. Coaches don't have to like the calls, but you tell them what the calls are, those are good. You guys just got to keep it going. Pot the ball. Good call, Jeff. It's not impossible to play defense from behind, but it's very difficult. Especially, it's almost impossible for a littler guy to try to play defense over a big guy from behind. You know, when 54 is in, he's the primary guy we're going to be focusing on in that paint. Okay, subs. John, your subs. As the C, we have the most time going down the court to check our partners and to check the table. We have to be diligent at that. Free throw mechanics, right? It'd have been nice to see Jeff and John. And John, you put up two, but both of you guys putting up one until he comes back with one to you. Yep, just like that. Good. That looks so much better. Because in a situation like that, if the lead screws that up somehow or another, you as a crew are protected, at least the two outside guys. Because then it really looks bad for the lead not paying attention. Yep. All right. Next thing we got to concentrate is getting our shooters. Your partner makes a call and we're shooting. The other two guys need to come in and let them know, I got your shooter. Unless you want to put the wrong shooter up on the free throw line we were just talking about in the NBA and the Division I, then you guys get in a lot of trouble and might get fired. But finding that shooter right away and bringing him to the line will save you a lot of headaches later. Thank you. One good thing about the running clock is that we can call as many fouls as we want to, and it doesn't affect the clock, right? So we need to get prepared to call those fouls. Each of the dribblers, there are guys reaching in and making body contact with the dribbler, it's a foul. Okay, subs. Jeff, sub. Yep. Okay, we only want one hand up. So John, that was good that you recognize it, but you need to pass that off once Jeff knows that. Make your presence known, just come on, just stop, stop, good. White ball. Rotation, Jeff.
Did you hit that 12 for pushing off over here?
Oh, I was looking down here, sorry. Who's in bonus and who's not? Yep, gotta be 2 feet out of the lane. You can't have one in there. It's just a lack of focus. So we have blue ball coming in, right? Okay, good.
I blew the jump ball.
Right. That ball was stolen, and U1's responsible for it. If you don't blow it, you could have blown it. I mean, that wasn't even an effort to try to wait till that ball was up there. Yep. So the other things too is you were making some great calls right away, right? On the big guy, the illegal screen. Coach doesn't like any calls that are made against this team, but we were setting him for a while. Blue was not doing anything illegal, you know?
Yeah.
Then now the big guy's back in, and a couple of the 33 is start when he's coming in the screen. He's starting to come in like this to push the guys away. So just look at it. There's a couple times when we talk about two hands on the dribbler. 30 White has the ball, right? And he's doing like this. And his defenders are having his hands all over his back. And that could have been from the sea or the trail. That's stuff we got to get. Then whenever they reach for the ball and they make contact with the dribbler, you know, there was one where Blue is trying to get the ball and he's missing the ball, but his arm and hand is making body contact with the dribbler. That's a foul. That's crappy defense. So we want to get crappy defense and bad defense all the time. But you guys are making the calls, which are good. And then a couple other issues that we'll just talk about later. So Blue has the ball. Yep. Solid whistle, let's get her started. So we know it's nice with that big guys. We know where the ball's going. So we know as a lead where we're going to focus our attention. Get to our base, and we make our decision from there. Gotta have been over there way before that, John. You need to be where that big guy is. Yep, good call. Especially for Jeff and Josh, what's great, John wasn't with us at the beginning when we were outside and we're talking about getting to your base and moving from there. Just look at what we were talking about compared to what he's showing here, and you'll see why it's important. Nice to have double whistle on it. We could have double whistle on that. And the right person took it. now is one. Both of you guys want to give him the one till he tells you one back there. Good job. That just looks so much better. On the next game of getting the shooter for the for your partner, who the shooter is. I like to have both you guys. Who's the shooter? Who's the shooter? Don't assume anything. Now, do we rotate on that? The ball was established in the backcourt, right? We do not have front court possession anymore. We do not rotate on that. Thank you. So blue got the rebound, right? So backcourt possession has been established. Do we rotate on backcourt established? Nope. What we would have done is you make the call and just keep going. On that one. It would look so good if you had blue hand up and point. And this way you had the wrong hand up to make the directional call. One thing we'll talk about at halftime, after the game, about how our mechanics are when we make directionals. Be watching the feet only. Don't worry about looking so high up. Watch the feet. Don't watch anything else. Know where the pivot foot is. Yep, you're sub, John. All right. Time out. So just on timeouts, what I want to see is that you turn to your partners first, ask where the possession of the ball is, then turn around and go to the table, all right?
So me pointing at him wasn't good enough?
Well, what I would want to have is make sure that your partners see you first. So just make it more of an effort. Like when you ask coach, full, okay, where's the ball? There, we all know that. Okay, full timeout, boom, and then come like.
Because even with it being a dead ball at that situation.
That's what you want to do, because my communication is more to you than anybody else. I don't care about the table or the coaches. So you want to make sure those two guys know it. Yeah, that was good, but what you want to is give them a couple of seconds to get to the huddle,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And then go to the table, boom. And there's nothing wrong with it, I was just saying, but I want to worry about them. Does he know what you had? He might have known what you had, but you want to make sure he knows what you had, that kind of crap.
I never know what
to
call. Yeah. Well, you're talking into a mic over here, that's why.
Yeah. Yeah, it's to myself, I just can't answer it. No, I have really no spot. Somebody could have it. Yeah, we're keying on that big guy, right? You know he's coming. Good. Thank you. Yeah, definitely. He's got to be there before he starts his jump. Okay, now we want to make sure we got one finger up to your guy until he tells you back there. This looks so much better. All right, guys, we're going to be under a minute. Do we know that? Nope, sorry, my fault. Okay, now he rotated. Do you know, John? Go! All right. Nice, Josh, on filling in as we were talking about. Your partners didn't pick up the rotation, but you filled in where you're supposed to. That was a foul, yep. That's two. That was the right call. Two shots. Each of us were going to tell them two. Yep. Remember, the C and the T. Your mindset is to make sure he doesn't screw it up. Give him no chance to screw it up. Okay, good. That just looks so much better. Now, when we can pick up the shooters and bring them to the line, that'll be even better. Yep. Shooter, 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 shooter. Don't ever take it for granted. You may never know in camp if the clinicians have talked to the coaches to set up a situation where the wrong shooter goes. It's been known to happen. So we're just about a minute under that one. Ooh. Okay, see, I would ask what stat, yep. Just put your back to the table. Tell your partner we're shooting, we're going running the line, we're good. And then turn around. Because We know where the ball is going to be spotted, what they can do and can't do. So we're under 4 minutes. Okay, don't let that bonus sneak up on you, right?
Right.
Okay. And make sure we communicate it between all of us that we know. The higher you go up in basketball, you have to be better at clock awareness. If we ever go to the shot clock, it's even going to be worse. But with one clock, we still need to know when it starts, when it stops, where the bonus is, who's shooting bonus. Now we're at 6 and 5, so we need to be really aware of who's going to be shooting when. Don't let this stuff sneak up on you. This is kind of like your pre-play preparation. Okay, what do we have? We have the time, we have the foul situation, we're getting ready to bring the ball in. All before it happens. John, I wish you were over on this side when that big guy was there. We know the ball's coming into the big guy. We need to be on his side to prepare for that. Good, Josh. You're staying on the big matchup there. That was good. You know where the ball is. You see where they're cutting in. Got a lot of action in that paint there. Don't care about the ball. Watch the feet. All right, we're good. Watch the feet. Okay, we came up with the inside hand. Remember, it's the outside hand, you know that. Nice rotation, Josh. How to come over, now I'd go back. No. It was straight up. There was no foul there. The offense created all the contact. Blow it dead, blow it dead. Yep. All right, everybody to the bench. We're good? Subs in? Yep. And since we blow that whistle dead, he has to come out. Okay, how many hands do we want up? Only one, the closest to the table, right? under a minute. Okay. Yep. All right, we're under a minute now. So let's just get together and talk about situations that's going to come up. We got a close game.
Yep. Guide us, but let us do it. Let's see if we know, okay?
Yeah.
I love that you're helping me, but you're not really helping me now.
So 21, they called a timeout, so 21 will be back.
21,
in the game.
21 can
just
be
so you know, okay. Just so you know, because you were down there.
That's what they had to do.
Okay. Yeah, they called a timeout, so he's out.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's actually in.
Well, I mean, he's out of timeouts.
He's
out.
We
got one.
We have one left over here.
We're in bonus,
yep,
right?
We're
like
bonus.
White and bonus.
So let's make sure you just watch. Who's going to try and score quick, and then they're going to either pressure or try to foul.
Yep.
That's what they're going to do. If they don't get that pressure initially, then they are
good
going
job.
To cause a foul here.
Right.
Okay. So make sure we stay on top and make sure the C stays home on this. Make sure you stay for that press.
What side are you inbounding on?
I'm inbounding on the same side I was.
Right side. Okay.
That's where he rebounded. The rebound was there, so we should stay where we are.
Good.
And the other C stay home. And
yep.
All right, good job. We got our plan.
All right.
That was good that we identified the plan that we have, and let's see how we execute it. That was a good rotation, Josh, too. Remember the big guy. Always with him. So we're in bonus both places, right? Who's what? All right. So in this case, the kids told us what was bonus, right? Before we started, we said we're going to get that. So we should have known the blue was in bonus. Boom, and foul there. I got your shooter. Okay, they have one to give. Yep. Okay, so they now are in bonus. So let's pick up the shooters. Assume nothing. Good. Nice job, Jeff, in controlling the situation. Okay, that could have been a defense. Yes. Shooter is who, though? Who is the shooter? All right, 20, that's right. See, that's where it comes and looks really nice. Jeff, you knew who the shooter was. If my other partner was coming, I got your shooter, and he has to just go ahead with that. That was a nice get, Josh. That was a nice get on that foul. That was excellent. I just wanted to see if we were going to get 20 to the line or not, or if somebody were going to let 34 go.
Guys, 22 seconds left right now. Blue's going to try the same thing. Score quick. Remember we have a bonus both ways?
Yep.
Blue, you almost figured it was trying to pound into that big guy.
Oh, that's
all they got. That's all they got there.
I'm gonna watch,
so that I'm not probably not going to move much around the baseline, just because unless I really have to.
You need to be on the big guy's
side.
Be on the big guy's side.
Because we really want to see everything, and we don't want to get caught moving around and miss something. Yep.
Who's going to make sure the clock starts?
I got it.
Okay, good.
Sure. I do.
All right. Four eyes is okay if we can do it. If not, all right. Shooter, okay. So primary, right? Jeff, you took it, you were here. That ball was underneath the hoop. We had a double whistle, whose primary is that? That's the game. Yep. That's the game. They don't have to bring it in. All right. Nice job, guys.